Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Moni from PTE Magic, and in today's video, we're going to talk about spelling in PTE. Many of you have probably heard a lot of different rumors going on about the extremely and oddly low scores in spelling, despite rechecking it many times during the test. And there's also different explanations and assumptions behind such a low score. So what is the real reason? One of the popular hypotheses that came to my attention is that if you used too many backspace and delete buttons during the test. But I was kind of skeptical about this theory and decided to test for myself. So I took the real test 2 days ago and intentionally used multiple, like over 100 of backspace and delete buttons during the test. And here's the result.
So you can see that although I deliberately used backspace throughout the whole test, my spelling score still remained pretty high, which is 85.
So you got the point now. So the second popular explanation is the inconsistent usage of British and American spelling.
In this sentence, the word analysis is in British English. And however, aging is American spelling. But in the marking criteria, it clearly says that we should only use one national variation in the response.
This sounds more sensible and makes more sense to me than the other one. A couple of months ago, I took a real test and purposely wrote incorrect words in filling the blanks listening and write from dictation. If I heard follow, I will write following. If I heard by, I would write on. So I did like 6 mistakes like that intentionally. This is what I got.
So in this case, even though I spelled all the words correctly, but I used completely different words from the correct answer, which result in my poor spelling score as well as reduced my listening score.
Another potential reason is the use of double spacing or incorrect spacing between paragraphs in the essays. So for example,
so there are double spacing in here, for example, and in here as well. And also there's extra spacing between paragraphs.
But you shouldn't worry too much about that because it won't affect your writing score. So here's an example of our students who receive low score in spelling but still score really high in writing. So the key takeaway is that enabling scores don't always affect the communicable score directly. But if your score report shows like low score in spelling as well as writing, it means that you really do have problem with spelling certain words. I will suggest to practice writing more without autocorrect, and then copy your writing into Grammarly.com, which is a very effective tool to check your writing and so that you can learn from your mistakes. Clearly, it's very difficult to truly comprehend and dig into the marking algorithm of Pearson, but I'm just explaining based on practical perspective and practical experience I've got, and really hope that this can help you some way. Again, I just wanted to say thank you for watching my videos, and I'm really sorry if I wasn't able to reply to all your messages, your inquiries and your comments on YouTube. But we will be having an upcoming webinar where you can ask me questions directly and we can have a specific discussions about PTE. Also, we will be offering new online classes, so please like and follow our new Facebook page, PTE Magic International, to stay updated of the new course. Thank you so much for watching, and until next time.